Okay, let's give Everfrost Udi a little field test. We got very damage intensive enemies. Probably going Kindle Gem this game. Play it safe for a while, and then mid to late game we smash him.
Our journey continues.
A little small talk with the Rakan.
Minions have spawned. Life
speaks through us. Always good to keep up the mental from your teammates. League is like 50% mental anyway. If your team's willing to win, you can win, probably. Don't quote me on that.
Right of the ancients.
Get the Phoenix reset. When you walk out of base, always use your Tiger or Phoenix already, so you got the mana back when you're at red buff or blue buff. And when you started, just use Tiger and Phoenix instantly after using it. So you get like a double Phoenix or a double Tiger. Yeah, splash all the Raptors with Phoenix. Clean, clear. Just like that.
Our spirits have merged. Supreme force. Heart of flame.
Could be difficult to get a gank going here. Top and mid lane are both pushing in.
From ashes.
While I'm halving towards top. So we're gonna do blue and grump at the same time. Since we're not looking to gank right now anyway. Smite that in case enemy junglers here.
United as one.
Yeah, that clear speed is fucking disgusting, what the hell.
Spirit must fly free.
If Nidalee is here, we can probably take her. Dark Harvest makes her way weaker in the early game than Electrocute.
Send their spirits to the wild.
I guess she's pathing bot, so bot lane should watch out. Oh, she is top. She just didn't went for a crab. It's a free kill. Yep. That's a free kill, baby. Well, gapping is what I do. Right, let's just reset here. Diving her is not worth it. Mid lane is pushed in. Nidalee is dead. None of my mates are in any danger. Still going for Kindle Gem, although our team is way ahead. I could go Blasting Wand here, since we are winning. But I'm gonna play it safe here. Yeah. Since Nidalee didn't went for the bot lane scuttle crab, maybe we can snatch that from her. Also, don't do what I do and stack your fucking smites. Use them. Use them when you can. I'm way late on my smites. Not accustomed to the new changes where you need to smite as much as possible. So you can get your 900 damage smite, since it doesn't scale with level anymore. Honestly, not a bad change from Riot. It's just weird that they lowered it from 900 damage instead of 1000. Just doesn't feel clean anymore. Especially because in the same patch they kept Jinx ult damage at epic monsters like Baron and Dragon at 1000. I was like, great, now Jinx Rocket can't outsmite me anymore. And then came the smite change that lowered it to 900 damage. And now that bitch can outsmite me again. Didn't even need to help you. Alright, alright.
Our spirits have merged.
Can probably sneak a Drake here. Since Nidalee is perfect top. She won't see it coming, since it's all only minute 6. Maybe we can also gank bot, but we need to decide here. I'm gonna go for the bot then gank. Okay, bad decision. Yeah, now that is perfect bot. Oh, he's not. Good. We can still sneak that. Usually I should be punished for that mistake. The enemy saw me bot lane. They should know I'm on drag. But in normal games and low elo, you can get away with a bunch of stuff. Yeah. Still have my smite for heal. Yeah, he doesn't dare. No shot, brother. You have any idea who you're dealing with? Yeah, let's not get ahead of ourselves here. Pack in my jungle, that's huge. That's huge. And boom. Got a lot of gold, I could go back, but I'm thinking I'm going to go for Raptors, maybe a mid lane gank, then reset and buff. A full clear would be really greedy right now with 1500 gold in the back. Yeah, okay. Mid lane is resetting. Yeah, no way I can gank that. Right. Perfect. Go for my blasting wand here. You usually don't want to go for Lost Chapter or build Lost Chapter last, because we really don't need the mana, and it gives 40 ability power for 1300 gold, and Blasting Wand does the same for 850. So it's really not worth your time or your gold to go for Lost Chapter. Just the Amplifying Tomes and some boots, and you're good. I do that blue, look for the scatter. Should be a free scatter grab. I don't think Nidalee can contest this. She might be top lane, because Yone is really going ham. Yep, there she is. You really gotta get a feel on where the enemy jungler is. So I just knew she was perfect in this way and looking to gank top lane, because Yone was pushing in for like 2 minutes straight. That's really unfortunate, he still had flash. It's a flash for flash trade, I guess. Maybe Ahri can make something out of it. She still has ult up. She's going for a Seeker's Arm Guard. It's a good move against that. Yeah, I believe she can kill him. Probably. He didn't even go back, which is super greedy of him. Now, Ari is gonna get free plates for sure. Okay, I finally got my blue smite. I took way longer than you should. Okay, that Gwen looks awfully gankable right now. She shows herself again. You don't want to use that blast plant too early, because she could have a ward in here, right? So you want to wait until she shows her, so you can instantly move after using the blast plant. See if you can make something happen on the mid lane. Okay, combo to me, you're good. It's not enough though. Super unfortunate, they both got away. Oh man. Alright, bot lane putting in the work. Okay, time to use our hex slash. Okay, he has a ward. See, I saw him moving back right there, and right before I hex slashed on his wave, I drifted with my mouse to the right so I would flash away from his lane to not waste any time or maybe get spotted. I wouldn't have gotten him anyway, so that's nice. In the last second, you can always decide to hex flash somewhere else. Bot lane is just cleaning up. God damn. Should be a free game.
Crush any barrier.
We can buy our Everfrost, but only with the debt limit. So we're going for the Scuttercrab and then reset. So we don't have to go into red numbers to get that. Maybe get a hero? I feel like we can beat Zed and Nidalee in the jungle when they can't go to their towers. Because let's face it, last time they were all running from us. We can kill them. Just need a chance. Yeah, they're not even contesting. Alright. Ah, that's rough. Yeah. Just gonna reset to get my Everfrost, then go for my red buff. If they didn't take Drake by then, we can maybe contest Drake. I got a lot of AD, so I'm going for the plated steel cap this game. Also, if you're just starting to play Everfrost Udyr, like, don't put Everfrost on smartcast like I do. I played it so many times, I know the range by now, but if you don't know the range, and you really want to use it the right way, not too early, not too late, you shouldn't put it on smartcast like I have. Alright, still didn't take Drake. We got a big power spike here. This should be good. Alright, we got speed boosters. Everfrost hits. Bear slap into Phoenix. Easy. Easy money right there. Beautiful. Very nice Shirelias here from Rakan also. And when your teammates do shit like that, like use their Shirelias to boost you up, man, ping that. It's good for them, man, to stroke that eco. It's stroke that ego, you know? League is all about mental. I smited way too late there, because I'm still not used to having a 900 damage smite this early in the game. Gotta be honest, the last 2 months I didn't even play League, and mostly Heroes of the Storm. That game is so addicting. But I'm getting back into League right now. Usually I don't even take League breaks from League. Sometimes games are so toxic, man. Just gotta take a break. I just can't keep up with that right now. I needed to stay back in case he was jumping back to his shadow, like he just did. Now we can't catch him. He has boots, right? Yeah. He already got better boots. He could outrun us easily. Ah, it's really terrible. In that case, you might even want to put some points into bear stance. If you can't surprise the enemy and you have to run after him, you're kind of struggling. Alright, good ult from Yone right here. Everfrost. Let's go. Boom. Out of here. Next, we're diving this. That's fucking awkward. You don't dare. You don't dare. Oh, she does dare. Okay, I fucked up. Okay. Yeah, when she flashed, she got a speed boost. I think she has, what you call it? I forgot the name of the rune. Where you get movement speed when you use a summoner spell. So she could outrun me after I flashed. Dang. That's okay though, that's okay. Your team has destroyed a tower. We really need our boots, so I'm building that. An enemy has been slain. Since I already got armor from plated steel caps, I'm not looking to build Warden's Mail too quickly. I'm just going for another Kindle Gem so I can spam Bear a little more. Get a little more sustain out of Turtle. Alright, Yone is showing himself very pushed in. The enemy team is probably going for him very soon. You can already see Nidalee moving up here. Zed is probably greedy around here. Yep, there she is. There she is. You really gotta get a feel from where the enemies are. And most of the time you can just look what your team is doing. And read from that where the enemy will show up. Yone was constantly showing himself on the top lane, so you knew sooner or later someone would go for him. So I moved up there and, you know, did my duty. See, now our bot lane is pushing with 3 people, so they will move all there. Yone is taking advantage of this, instantly teleporting top lane. And I'm gonna waste another fucking Rift Herald, like I did with the last one. Ah, but this time I'm gonna play as it. Probably top lane. Doing top. That was way too close. God damn. God damn. Baron almost denied us. Okay, I'm gonna put a point here in Bear. Since I got some good sustain already and I'm way too slow. beautiful setup from the Yone here. That slice to the back, followed up by my Kamehameha. It's a beautiful combo. I don't get hooked here. Let that Herald do the work. That Yone is just shining and dining on them, man. Yeah, no, I don't think... Oh! That turret range?
Okay.
Man, if I didn't dodge that Pyke ulti... If I didn't dodge that Pyke ult, that tower wouldn't have gotten me. I didn't think Yone would kill him fast enough for the Pyke ult to not even go through. Yeah, not even Yone can tank that. The team is getting a free Drake though. Nidalee is dead.
We breathe once
and we're already back in the game. And like, it's bad that I died there, of course, but we got 2 kills out of it and a turret, so can't be mad about that.
Supreme.
Sometimes you just gotta trade. Alright, let's see if I can help my team here. Secure that. Pyke was looking for the steer. I don't fuck with that. You see, like, how he used the blast plant and blasted himself over the bush and onto the lane, so the minion spotted him. You don't want to do that when using Hex Slash. Or a blast plant. Okay, jet boosters are on. Let's go. He's going on another target, but I'm really feeling the Kaisar here. It's a little unfortunate for Rakan. I can't help you. My Everfrost is down. Ever since they changed Everfrost from 20 seconds to 30 seconds, it's still fine, especially if you get your Randuin's Omen. But if somebody would play this build with Ingenious Hunter to get item cooldown reduction, can't be mad about that. I'm close to doing it myself, honestly. There's many variations you could do. You could also go Celerity for extra movement speed on your bear, and also buff your approach velocity with it.
Let's
see if we can help Yone out here. That's just terrible. Nice, okay. Oh, that Rakan is something else. Could have worked with that. Come on, I sidestepped that. I'm leaving my team hanging here right now. Oh my god. Yeah, that Zed is turning out to be a little bit of a problem. We got our Randuin's Omen though.
Your turret has been destroyed.
When you're dead though, you're not out of the game, right? You, like, use your death timer. When you're dead, already look on the map, what's up, what can I do, mid lane is being pushed, do I defend that, blue buff is up, do I take that, Baron is up, do we want that, right? So when you're dead, don't just shop and chill, like, look around, what can you do? I can help my team here, it's an easy pickup. If we are able to chase it. Again, I'm chasing a different target than my Khan. We got different ideas right now. This is why communication is so important. If he pings what target he wants to go on, I can follow through. It's not the issue here. Like, we just got different ideas. Alright, that's a Baron. Now what do we do with that? Push lane. Teamfight. Could secure our Ocean Soul with that. I think we should do that. Watch out for the Ocean Soul. Lock him down, just like that maybe. Rakan knock up into my Everfrost into Bear Slap. He couldn't move, man. This is what it's all about. Detain that motherfucker. That is what this build is all about. This dude is 10-3. He was feeling himself. But if he gets CC'd, he can be as fat as you want, man. You can't touch me. Alright, we might be able to finish this with Baron minions. Three enemies dead. Runyon's Omen here to reduce her attack damage and slow her. Just run her down, just like that. Alright, so honestly I got a little lucky with my team here, but we still had some clean moments. It's okay. Can't be mad about that. Alright, and that's that. I hope you could learn a little bit out of it. And let me know your experience about the Everfrost deer.